Hey there, friends. Good morning. I hope you all are doing well today. My name is Rabbit, and welcome to episode number 51 of Let's Play Paladin's Quest for the Super Nintendo Entertainment System. In our last episode, we just returned from the island that our mom had spoken to us about. I don't know why I don't internalize the names of these places. I'm pretty sure Dazden Island or something to that effect. And she was correct that within its depths, there was in fact a legendary question mark behind that sword, which I believe is called the Thunder Saber. Don't hold me to the saber part, but it's a very cool sword that it does an AoE set of bolts across the battle map. So very interesting. Not, I think, thematically appropriate for Chesney. I feel like he's more of the fire guy, but, you know, I appreciate that they like to switch it up a little bit. So immediately following us finding this weapon and hopping back on our boat to head back to Railed, we came here and this is what was before us. So let's go ahead and start walking around, talking to folks and seeing what, in fact, went down. Unmoving dead. Well, great, Chesney, thanks for that. Well, hopefully you got, whoa, what did that just say? I clicked way too fast. I wasn't expecting him to talk to me. I was trying to approach him to talk to him. Perhaps because he saw me first, it prompted him to say something. That's very interesting. Well, you guys can always pause the video and see exactly what he said. And I'm sure that the other ones that we're going to stumble upon are going to say something similar to what this one said, if not exactly what was said to us. So we'll use Soa's crown and Chen will use his right hand. I really regret not getting rid of his ass at the end of our last episode, or I should say prior to us entering town. But I did not, and I don't want to head back outside. We might not even be able to go back outside. So we'll keep Chen for a little bit longer. He's really holding on here, but it's all good, Chen. Maybe he can prove himself to be amazing. I don't think he will, but oh, these poor people. Good thing this town isn't that big and crazy. Will you look at me? I want to see if that's what happened. Is he gonna fucking look at me? Do you guys see this? Look at me. What is he doing? Will you turn around? Okay, there we go. Chesney, prepare yourself. So is that what the other one said? I'm not really sure. Okay, we'll just leave this fight in because I think it'll be easy peasy. We're just gonna blast on through. But more importantly, what's more important than the fact that all of Chesney's home folks are dying? Probably not my story about gamers and my video gaming friends and personalities and communities I've been a part of in the past. But what I was sharing with you guys is that for me, I have always found myself to be a little bit more social than most of the other gaming friends that I've had, with the exception of, I would say there are a few exceptions, but this girl has been texting me this morning. Her name is Courtney, or that's what we'll call her anyway. And she is very interesting to me because I think when we first met each other, the other person was like, wait a minute, you're really into video games? Because as I was sharing with you guys towards the end of our last episode, I think I wouldn't call myself a hardcore gamer, but maybe others would. Oh, he didn't even fight me. Okay, well, I guess he doesn't care that much. Let's go see if our mom's actually okay, and then I'll talk to you more about this. Oh, good, we got here just in time. So, you came back, Chesney. Lord Zagos is most angry. You're doomed. I really don't think, oh, this one's the Admiral, whereas the other ones were what, just sergeants? Well, I don't think we really have too much to be worried about, but okay, buddy, if you think you've got what it takes to take us down, bring it on, my friend, bring it on. I don't know if Chen is the right, choice to have here, but we're gonna make this work. You know what I'm actually gonna do? I'm gonna put the power robe on him, and he's just gonna go to town with his fists of fury, or at least I hope they're gonna dish out some furious attacks and blows. All we can do is just wait and see. Well, anyhow, when I first met Courtney, she was really surprised that I was a big gamer, and I was surprised that she was a big gamer because I think, again, I wouldn't consider myself to be too hardcore, even though I think my knowledge of video games is, I would say, fairly expansive just due to the fact that I've played them for a long time. Like, you see this a lot where there are people that say they're gamers, but I feel like they really just appropriate gamer culture because it's more trendy now to do it, and especially I think if you want to mix as a woman your sexuality with being a gamer, there's a lot that you really can exploit, I think, regardless of what your intentions are. Maybe some people aren't necessarily doing it with ill intentions, but I think it's interesting to me that's a thing now, that people who don't really seem to embody a lot of knowledge of games and they are not even that interested in really talking about the games themselves, unless it fits a specific agenda or whatever it is that they're trying to achieve. I just think it's quite fascinating to me. So maybe that's another type of gamer personality. I was sharing with you guys that most of the people I've met who are gamers tend to be either more of like the shyer, nerdy stereotype, that they kind of do their own thing and keep it moving and they enjoy video games, but they don't play that socially, unless you count maybe some of their MMO experiences might be considered more social. But in terms of them just interacting with a lot of other people and a lot of other gamers, it's not like a huge thing. Like, they're not the type of person that would throw Mario Party parties or DDR parties. But again, there's a whole lot of variety. And I've also met people that are more of those like hardcore, like they've always got to win, they're always competing, they play a lot of MOBAs, they play a lot of real-time strategy games, and they're just always gaming, and they know the ins and outs of a lot of different games. They know about all the developers involved in different games. They're subscribed to a bunch of gaming magazines. Like, you guys get the drift. Like, I would call that a hardcore person, where I'm on the spectrum. I lean maybe more towards that than someone who, I guess you could throw casual gamers in there too, people that maybe play just like one type of game, like a life simulator maybe, or mobile games every once in a while. Like, they're still gamers, but I guess they would probably be the far end of casual. But again, I'll get to Courtney in just a second. Please forgive us, Lord Zagos. What's there to forgive? He should have known you didn't stand a chance. Mom, are you okay? Is that you, Chesney? Mother will be all right. Now listen closely to what I have to say. Chesney, you are not my real child. Oh, okay. Well, that's getting to the fucking point. Let's just be real, Mom. You couldn't, you know, break this a little softer to me. But I guess, to be fair, everything's on fire and most people are dead. So maybe she feels like, you know, we don't really have all of the time for me to be pussyfooting around. Here's the fucking facts, Chesney. When a huge tsunami struck this town 13 years ago, Dorga, my husband, perished. Oh my God, what a name. When I came to the beach the next day, a strange ship had washed up. You were aboard that ship. I've raised you, thinking you were Dorga. Aw, come back to me. That's both sweet and kind of creepy. Mom, so you raised me like I was dad's spirits? Interesting. That ship is hidden beneath the bed. You may be able to take that ship out to sea again. Be careful when you reach the ocean. You must not underestimate the ocean. Remember, the ship is under the bed. Oh, Chesney, my son. What bed? I'll be all right. Now hurry and leave here by the ship under the bed. It's dangerous outside. Does she mean in this room? The bedroom? Mama, you are tripping. Can I not leave? The door won't open. It's barred from outside. Oh my gosh, I didn't even go check on the elder. I'm sure this isn't the case, but I really hope there's not like a chest out there that I needed to do something with. But all right, game. How the hell? Well, I can't interact with this bed. And I can't get outside, so what do I do now, Mom? I'll be all right. Now hurry and leave here by the ship under the bed. I can't get under the bed, Mom, if the door won't let me outside and the bed won't move, unless I'm doing something wrong. Let's see. Okay, so I guess I had to specifically examine this spot. The bed moves, revealing a staircase. Ooh, very creepy. I feel bad just leaving her here. You would think she would come with us. Oh. Is this the ship she was referencing? There is a map in the ship. If you press the map button, whoa, this music changed real quick. If you press the map button while aboard the ship, you can see the map at any time. Oh, okay. That's interesting. No, back out. I don't know what, maybe I have to be out for it to work? I'm not sure what it means. Can I get rid of Chen? This probably shouldn't be my priority thing to do immediately right now, but I gotta get rid of him before more shit hits the fan. It was a short acquaintance, but a happy one. Let's meet again, blah, blah, blah. Get the fuck out of my party. It was nice to know you, but even nicer to get rid of you. I like this music, you guys. This is, it's very, I wouldn't necessarily describe it as soothing, but it's, oh, I can't use it here. I guess I have to be outside. I love this, that we have an actual ship. Holy guacamole, this is crazy. I feel like they switched up the mechanics on us very fast. Oh, is this the town? Can I get off though to see? No, I can't. So there goes, oh, so I can re-enter. And is everyone just gone? Weird. All the bodies are gone, the flames are gone, with the exception, it looks like the Elder's Hut is fine. And I say this, oh, it's just so that you can save, but I guess the Elder would have died. How come no one ever kills you? You're always just chilling here, lady, like there's not a care in the world. But okay, is it a little bit wrong? Total aside, and maybe I shouldn't even say this, that, wait, where's my mom? What the fuck? Where did mom go? Where is my mom? Oh, game, this is uncool. Well, I guess she did tell us to leave, and I'm guessing it would be weird if she was just still sitting there. But does this mean she died? Oh my God, you guys, I don't even know. But okay, one thing at a time, Rabbit, one thing at a time. Let's get back Mouth. And I may eventually let go of Hawk and try back out Lily, Chacon, or Bean. I don't know. I'm just worried, though, that their levels are going to be quite low. Again, we'll just cross that bridge when we get to it. Well, we meet again, says Mouth. Want to travel with me again? You bet your sweet bippy. Get right into this party. All right, so our team should be pretty decent. Or I'm hoping it's going to be decent. I'm still not wholly sold on, oh, I can actually go into the ocean now. Do you guys see this? But I first want to make sure there's not something else that we can kind of check out around here. You guys know me. I got to exhaust all my options before I feel comfortable moving on into uncharted territory. So, Courtney, I was telling you guys, she is crazy. And when we first met each other, I think we surprised the other person because I wasn't expecting her to be as big of a gamer as she actually was. And I don't think she was expecting me to be as big of a gamer, or I guess maybe as long-standing of a gamer as I was. And she's interesting also in the fact that she's quite chatty and quite outgoing. I wouldn't consider myself to be an exceptionally talkative person, but we've gone over this before in different Let's Plays if you guys have followed me for a while, that I mean, as someone who is in education and I'm an instructor, I have to be able to talk. I present at wellness conferences and I do all of that good stuff, so I would not be able to be successful in my work in health education and research if I was super shy. It just would not work, like, at all. So I would say that I am introverted in the sense that I enjoy being by myself, but I'm kind of an extroverted introvert, if you will, where I do well speaking to strangers and I do well carrying on a conversation and I can just banter about anything and I don't really feel uncomfortable doing it. But I will say that being in social situations is draining for me. Whereas for someone like Andrew, who is extroverted 100% to T, far end of the spectrum for extroverts, he just feeds off the energy of other people and he gets more animated the more people that are around him. He gets more excited the more people are talking to him or listening to him tell a story. It really fuels him and it feeds his energy, whereas it drains my energy, although I have a big enough pool to where it doesn't throw me off like I think it does some people. So Courtney is more like Andrew, where I would say she does a really good job of, I'd say, keeping up with people, and she likes to talk and just bullshit, and she's very special, I think, in that. So she's actually a journalist, and so she does a lot of, I think, research, and I wouldn't say she does any broadcasting, but she does a lot of, like, developments for businesses. She does a lot of interviewing. She's very good at what she does as a journalist and as a journalism person, like just someone who's very passionate about that type of world. Because I've met people that are journalists, but they're still a little shyer, like they do mostly written. Okay, now I need to test out what the fuck did they mean by a map. Hold on. Map button. Oh, but I don't really know where the hell am I going. There's more for us to see. Oh my gosh, you guys. Now here's the thing that trips me up in games sometimes. When you just have full open access to anything you could imagine, whereas you didn't before, and there's not a whole lot of direction as to where you need to go. Because honestly, I feel like I kind of want to go and check out those islands immediately to the east of us, where the little blinking dot with the white box around it. So we could check out those islands. There's also a bigger island somewhat southeast from where we're at, but we could go back and see. There are a couple little spots that I don't know if we've checked out before, and I don't want to be here all day tapping in and out. So you know what? We're almost up on time anyway. This might be a good stopping point, and maybe I will drag us somewhere. Maybe I should actually say first. Maybe I will go back and talk to that lady back in Railed, but I think what I'm going to do is we'll part ways here. I will go save. And I will bring us back outside of an island that I choose to go to. I think it's going to take a minute for us to get there together anyway, and I'd rather just spare you all of that. So, and I know I'm the queen of dragging my stories out for 3 fucking videos because there's just so much to comment on in the game, and I don't want to talk all about myself when there's just so much to see. So you guys will have to excuse me. This isn't even really that exciting of a story. So I feel like I've built it up now, and I'm like, oh wow, Courtney is this very extravagant, out there person, and just a true gamer to the sense that she's always been a gamer. She's very interested in gaming culture. She loves going to conventions. She plays a variety of things. She's very into, I think, MMOs, though. That's like her jam, and WoW in particular, with WoW Vanilla / WoW Classic being announced, she's losing her mind and blowing up, and she's been blowing up my phone about it for a little while. So I will leave you guys with that, and then I'll talk a little bit more just about how weird she is, but how much I love her at the same time. She fucking kills me. So thanks for watching, everyone. As always, my name is Rabbit. This is our run through Paladin's Quest on the Super Nintendo Entertainment System, and I'll be honest, I'm a little bit nervous about knowing exactly where we need to be going, but as always, when we reach points like this in video games, if there is a lot of downtime or we kind of hit a bit of a wall where I'm not sure what comes next, I will, of course, figure that out without you, and I'll just kind of bring you back when we know exactly where we need to be. And I will always show you on the map where we'll be headed next. So don't you worry about a thing, everyone. I'll try to keep this as streamlined as possible. But of course, with me, you guys already know, anything can happen. So take care, everyone. Be good. And I greatly look forward to seeing you in just a moment in episode number 52, where hopefully we will be outside of a new interesting place that we haven't seen before, or maybe we'll revisit a place that we had been to in the past, and I just want to triple check and make sure nothing new has happened. I'm thinking real hard, but I'll just decide that on my own. So I'll see you guys in just a moment, and as always, I will catch you up to speed with what choices I ended up making without you. I'll see y'all there.